Hi everyone, Alexis Avila of Prepped and Polish LLC here in South Natick, Massachusetts. On the ACT math section, it's easy to make careless mistakes if you're not careful. My friend and special guest Dobril from actquantum.com based in California is going to explain to you a typical problem students often miss on the ACT math section involving exponents. Dobril, take it away.
So here I want to give you an example of a common type of exponent problem that shows up on the ACT and sort of the temptations that students have in terms of simplifying it. So I'll start with this first piece here, 2x cubed to the power of 4. And so here we're raising each of these components to the fourth power. So this is equivalent to 2 to the 4 times x cubed to the fourth. And here 2 to the 4, that's just 16. And to understand this really means I'm going to multiply x cubed 4 times. And that is equivalent to having a set of 12 x's. So this is really the same as x to the 12. Or in other words, we're just adding the exponents. So the rule when you have this, this is what's called power of power, is that you multiply. So this is x to the power of 3 times 4, not x to the 7. Common mistake in terms of adding those. So that expression is 16 times x to the 12. And also, the rule that I used here where I distributed that exponent comes from if you have two numbers raised to the power m, this is a to the power m times b to the power of m, because really this means that we have m of these expressions, and collectively that means, because it's multiplication, we can change the order, that we have m a's and m b's. So that's what we're doing here. Now if we look at the second piece of this as 2x4 to the third, that again, we do the same thing, 2 cubed times x4 to the third. Now that is 8. And then again, we get here, in this case, x to the 12. Now, if you go back to the original expression, it's made up of some of those two terms. So we're looking at 16 times x to the 12 plus 8 times x to the 12. Now, again, here, a common temptation would be this is 24 times x to the 24. None of that applies. You can't just add these exponents. In fact, a better way to think about this is to factor x to the 12, and then this becomes 24 times x to the 12. I think a common temptation for these types of exponent problems is if you're given x to the 10 plus x to the 10, that's not x to the 20. Instead, think of factoring x to the 10. In this case, this would be just 2 times x to the 10. Or another type of example is x to the 10 plus x to the 11. It's best to handle it by factoring x to the 10. And you can't really just add this and say this is equal to x to the 21. So watch out for those temptations. And then to summarize sort of the operation we did here is that we have x cubed to the 4 is same as x4 to the 3rd. So here it really doesn't matter where the exponent is. And this is equal to x to the 12, not equal to x to the 7. That's the common one you want to watch out for. And so to summarize here, this original expression we started is equivalent to 24 times x to the 12, which is answer choice D.
Thank you, Dobril. That was very helpful. If you have any further questions, you can email me at alexis@preppedandpolished.com, and also be sure to visit my friend Dobril's site. It has wonderful explanations to ACT problems. That's www.actquantum.com. Good luck on your ACT test, and I'll talk to you soon.